Today we are going to discuss about the topic force exerted by a jet of water on an unsymmetrical moving curved plate when jet strikes tangentially at one of the tips. Coming to the topic, first of all draw the inlet and outlet velocity triangles at the vane. This is the curved plate vane moving in the horizontal direction. Jet of water is being through tangential direction. At the starting point of vane, we consider it as V1. End point, if we consider V2. This absolute velocity V1 and V2 furtherly divided into two types, two components. That is VF1 and VW1 at inlet. Outlet VF2, VW2. Where VF1 and VF2 equal to VF1 comma VF2 equal velocity of flow at the inlet and outlet. Next, VW1 comma VW2 equal to velocity of the virrel at the inlet and outlet. As per this is moving curved plate. That's why plate moves relative velocity VR1. Relative velocity VR1, VR2 is added to inlet and outlet. Where VR1, VR2 equal to relative velocity of the jet at the inlet and outlet. This distance is added to U1 in the inlet, UT equal to outlet. This triangle is also called as the inlet velocity triangle. This triangle is also called as the outlet velocity triangles. Theta comma pi equal to tip angles inlet and outlets. Alpha comma beta equal to angles which the absolute velocity makes at the inlet and outlet. Now let us, if the vane is smooth and is having velocity in the direction of motion at the inlet and outlet equal, then we have U1 equal to U2 equal to U. Assume there is no friction because vane is smooth. So VR1 equal to VR2. That means relative velocity VR1 inlet equal to relative velocity outlet. Next, we have to find out F of X. That means force exerted by the jet in the direction of motion. F of X equal to mass of water striking per second into changing velocity. Next step, mass of water striking per second into initial velocity with which jet strikes in the direction of motion minus final velocity in the direction of motion. Now let us first find out mass of water striking the vane per second, that equal to rho a VR1. Note, F equal to M delta V according to momentum principle. Mass of water per second written as rho Q. Delta V changing velocity V1 minus V2. Q equal to AV. Continuity equation Q equal to AV. So AV V1 minus V2. We are not taking changing velocity in the particular equation because furtherly we have to find out the same, only considering the mass value rho a v, where a equal to area of jet of water, VR1 equal to relative velocity at inlet. Next we have to find out initial velocity of the jet striking in the direction of motion, that equal to vr1. So the component this velocity in the direction of motion vr1 cos theta. Refer to the diagram. That means horizontal component vr1 cos theta. Vr1 cos theta. Next, cos theta equal to vw1 minus u1 by v1. Now considering the triangle BCD, applying the cos theta equal to CD by BC. That means CD equal to VW1 minus U1. VW1 minus U1 divided by hypotenuse. That means VR1. VR1. So cos theta VR1 equal to VW1 minus U1. Similarly, next we have to find out the final velocity of the outlet triangle in the direction of motion. That means minus Vr2 cos pi. Minus Vr2 cos pi. Vr2 cos minus U2 plus Vw2. Cos pi equal to, consider triangle EGH equal to VW plus U2 plus VW2. U2 plus VW2 by VR2. VR2 cos pi equal to, therefore VR2 cos pi equal to minus U2 plus VW. Negative sign is taken as the component of VR2 in the direction of motion in the opposite direction. This is the direction of motion, but VR2 direction of motion is opposite direction. So negative sign is taken. Substituting the values in the equation 1, f of x equal to mass of water per second into initial velocity jet striking the plate minus final velocity jet striking the plate. That means rho a vr1 vw1 minus u2 plus vw2. Coming to the next step, rho a vr1 vw1 minus u1 minus of u2 minus vw2. That equal to rho a vr1 vw1 minus u1 as per minus equal to plus u2 plus vw2. F of x equal to rho a vr1 vw1 plus vw2. Therefore note u1 equal to ut equal to u, because vane is smooth, so we are considering u1 equal to u2 equal to u. Next we have to find out the above equation is true only beta angle shown in figure acute angle. Next we have to find out beta equal to 90 degrees, the vwt equal to 0. Refer the above figure. Beta equal to 90 degrees, we form straight line. So beta equal to 90 degrees. See the, then above equation becomes f of x equal to rho a vr1 vw1 plus 0. F of x equal to rho a vr1 vw1. If beta greater than 90, f of x will become f of x equal to rho a vr1 vw1 minus vw2. Thus in generally f of x is written as f of x equal to rho a vr1 vw1 plus or minus vw2. These conditions is very useful to problems. Next, finally find out the work done per second unit weight of the fluid striking per second equal to f of x into u. Weight of fluid striking per second, rho a vr1 VW1 plus VW2 into U. Water striking, fluid striking, G into rho A, VR1, Newton meter per second. Finally, 1 by G, VW1 plus VW2 into U, Newton meter per Newton. Now we find out work done per second, that equal to f of x into u. In the previous equation, we have to find out the f of x value. F of x equal to rho a vr1 vw1 plus vw2 into u. Now finally we have to find out the efficiency, that equal to output by input, where output equal to f of x. f of x in the previous equation we have to already find out, that means rho a vr1 vw1 plus vw2 into u. Input equal to kinetic energy. Already you know the formula for kinetic energy, that is input, which is half mv square. Already you know the value of m, so m equal to rho a v1 square. Finally eta equal to rho a vr1 vw1 plus vw2 into u of rho a v1 cube. Therefore eta equal to 2 vr1 vw1 plus vw2 by v1 cube into u.